Iga is Liz with Fantastic Canine Training, and I just want to make this quick little video today to show you guys which dog you should correct and advocate for when something like this happens. So I'm gonna use these little things as dogs. So let's say you have dog number one, the dog here has a toy. Dog number two doesn't have anything, he's just hanging out. Dog number one has a toy, chilling on it, chewing on his bone, whatever, toy, bone, anything that's valuable. Dog number two come and approaches dog number one. Dog number one growls. What should dog number two do? Dog number two should move away, right? In this scenario, we do absolutely do allow growling. So let's say dog number one growled and dog number two didn't understand the meaning of the growl and it kept coming forward. Boom, the dogs get into a fight, right? So before that happens, so you have to watch your dogs like 24/7, guys. Dogs are like your 3-year-old kid. They can't be unsupervised. So dog number one has the bone or toy, valuable item. Dog number two comes and the human needs to step in and remove dog number two, right? You have to advocate for dog number one. It's absolutely okay in the dog world. If this dog has a valuable item and dog number two approaches, we advocate for this dog. And then remove dog number two away to keep things under control. And they understand, and dogs will understand that you have things under control when something uncomfortable happens. So then this dog doesn't have to growl to throw this dog away, to put this dog away, right? But anyway, this was just my little story on how to advocate for your dogs. In this specific scenario, you absolutely advocate for the dog with the bone, right? This is just the annoying dog that wants everything that this dog wants. If dog number one had the bone or toy or valuable items and this was a human, we absolutely correct dog number one. I hope that makes sense to you guys. If you have any questions, please post below. Me and Miley will be happy to help you.